At Farnborough International Airshow 2024, Boom Supersonic unveiled its flight deck for the Overture. The company said it had reinvented the cockpit with a design that centers on pilots with safety at the forefront. Simple Flying's managing director, Joanna Bailey, caught up with Boom at their chalet to take a look at the new flight deck and find out what's new and interesting about this design. Boom started to design the new flight deck around 2.5 years ago. The group was tasked with creating a cockpit that promises to deliver on ergonomics and comfort, as well as improve situational awareness for the crew, and while also integrating emerging technologies like automation. Naturally, safety would be at the heart of any design. Designing a cockpit for Overture wasn't easy. Like Concorde, it is narrow and pointed at the end, meaning there's less real estate to play with than on traditional aircraft. Pilot visibility can be an issue as well, so there are plenty of considerations to be incorporated into the design. The first iterations were designed using CAD or computer-aided design, and then transposed into VR for pilots to evaluate the proposal. Pilots then had the opportunity to assess whether the angles on displays were right, get a feel for how everything fit into the cockpit, and get a sense of comfort levels. Once the VR designs were refined, Boom started making mock-ups of the layout. By integrating augmented reality or AR into the plans, pilots could sit in a seat and visualize where controls would be and how everything would fit together. From here, the company iterated on things like seat height and position and the locations of critical components. Finally, a complete mock-up including 3D printed components was made, allowing pilots to experience the design hands-on. And so, by the time Farnborough Airshow 2024 rolled around, Boom had integrated its final cockpit design into a working simulator, which some of the Simple Flying team had the pleasure of flying. Boom announced in December 2023 that the Honeywell Anthem integrated flight deck would form the basis of the Overture's avionics. At the time of making this video, the technology is not yet certified by the FAA, but first flew in May 2023 on a Pilatus PC-12. Thus, the flight deck is well on the path to approval. Boom has customized the flight deck to some extent and added some other bits and pieces to create a unique and hopefully lovely flying experience. Some of the most interesting features include the following. Large 17-inch touchscreens. Hundreds of breakers and buttons found in a normal cockpit have been replaced with several huge high-definition touchscreens. Every single function of the aircraft is available via the software, although the company is retaining some physical controls for critical functions, including side stick, throttle, and landing gear. Boom went with side sticks after consultation with pilots who agreed that these were better for comfort in flight. The two BAE side sticks are active, meaning what happens on the left also happens on the right, so there's no disagreement possible between pilot and co-pilot. They also get feedback from the aircraft so the pilots can actually feel what's happening to the plane. Augmented reality and auto land. Taking cues from the success of the XB-1 prototype systems and flights, Overture pilots will use AR for takeoff and landing. The augmented reality will give pilots excellent visibility outside and around the aircraft, letting them see through the walls of the plane. Pilots will also have the option to use an auto land feature for safe touchdowns. This technology-first development process has produced what is a very technology-first flight deck. Boom also says that Overtures will be able to receive software updates over the air, theoretically making updating your supersonic jet as simple as updating your iPhone. Augmented reality is making waves all over the industry, but Boom will be the first to implement it as part of the equipment list on a newly built aircraft. Overture pilots will use the Universal Avionics Skylens 2 head-worn devices, which integrate views and signals from cameras and sensors all around the aircraft to provide enhanced situational awareness. Most importantly for Boom, this way of providing oversight of the outside world means there will be no need for a droop nose, as was necessary for Concorde. This would have added huge complexities and cost to the project, but thanks to modern technology, we have a more elegant solution. Blake Scholl, founder and CEO of Boom Supersonic, stated, "Following XB-1's successful test flight, we're accelerating. Overture features an all-new flight deck incorporating extensive pilot feedback, resulting in a flying experience that is both innovative and instantly familiar. At the Boom Chalet, some of the Simple Flying team got to experience landing the Overture at London Heathrow Airport. The Boom crew were running a competition for pilots, evaluating success by the level of G's at the point of touchdown. We didn't win, sadly, but put in a good showing. Abid Habib, a journalist at Simple Flying, said that the cockpit interface is quite user-friendly, akin to that of the A350 cockpit. He notes that since the Overture has decided to utilise the side stick rather than the yoke, it'll be easier for Airbus pilots to integrate into the Overture in the future. Feedback from our team and others flying the sim was that it was very responsive and the position was comfortable. We spotted that Boom had some pretty cool pedals in development, although they're going to be a little smaller once finalised, which sport the Boom logo embossed into the metal. Mike Bannister, former chief Concorde pilot for British Airways, was also at the show and tried landing the Overture. This is what he said in terms of feedback. "I've long believed that Overture is the rightful successor to Concorde. After experiencing Overture's flight deck, which is incredibly well designed and delightful to fly, my excitement and enthusiasm for this aircraft has only intensified. There is a lot of work taking place to bring this supersonic passenger aircraft to market. This includes progress with Symphony, the engine that'll power Overture. In October 2023, the Symphony team successfully completed the engine's conceptual design review. This paved the way for hardware rig tests, which are now underway. Boom has also accelerated the development of a full-scale engine core, which will be operational in late 2025. The other big, somewhat recent update is that Boom has completed the construction of its Overture Superfactory, which is located in Greensboro, North Carolina. Announced as completed on June 17, 2024, the first assembly line is planned to produce 33 Overture supersonic aircraft annually. A planned second assembly line will double aircraft production to 66 each year. The construction of the building was completed in less than 17 months after breaking ground, and so Boom is now focused on installing tooling and operationalising production. And so, that's a little bit about our experience with the future flight deck of the Boom Overture and the latest progress with this exciting new aircraft. Over-the-air updates, augmented reality and several large touchscreens all sound nice, but such technologies have their respective issues. Are systems vulnerable to remote hacking? What happens if a touchscreen fails? Well, we can only hope that Boom, its partners and aviation regulators have thought these things through. But what do you think of the technology that has been integrated into this upcoming jet? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment.
Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.